My name is Sijia. I know my first name is probably a little bit hard to pronounce for a lot of non-Chinese speakers. It actually means homesickness. So I don't know, my parents probably might foresee that I will do a very long graduate degree outside of China. My research is in the general area of message effects, but in those social interactions. So traditionally, the research on message effects has been very heavily focused upon individual level, message processing, reception, production, or retransmission. So it takes heavily on a psychological perspective. But with giving this rise of a new media environment, where it is social interaction and social influence increasingly playing a bigger role in terms of how we process and produce messages. So I think it is naturally to bring these two perspectives together. So in my dissertation work, I will actually focus a bit more on, it is still on the umbrella of messaging effects during social interactions, but with a slightly more focused area. That is, I want to study basically the moral aspects of those dynamics. So what kind of moral appeals the messages can make to change people's opinions about controversial health and scientific issues. Let's say climate change. Traditionally, we know that climate change is very hard to, for example, make a conservatives sort of bring them on board to believe that climate change is real and there's a need for government as the international community as a whole to take interventions. But actually, there's some studies that are using insights from moral psychology. For example, if you frame the issue of climate change, not as in the typical moral values the liberals will endorse, for example, caring for the environment, caring for the earth in general. By the way, it's typically found that the liberals are pretty responsive to moral appeals like harm and care, right? But if you frame in the kind of things that conservatives will typically find repealing and resonating, for example, issues that if you don't stop climate change, that the earth will be increasingly, you will see being polluted by a lot of industrial emissions of dirty things. And also you can frame it as more like a responsibility. As a loyal citizen to the country, a loyal member of the global community as a whole, the sense of loyalty will be more appealing to them. So it depends on how you sort of frame the same issue, but in different kind of moral terms, it might have their effects and more or less appealing to different people. If you make the right sort of moral framing, or kind of sort of tailor the moral appeals to people, right? Wouldn't it be possible to make people basically sort of make them can fight against the typical social influence? For example, in the literature on public deliberation, we have this issue about the spiral silence. So which is the idea that if you see the majority of the discussion members will be taking a position other than my own, right? Because due to this perceived social pressure, I will become increasingly silent and to be fearful of expressing my own opinions. But my argument is, if you can make somehow through message interventions, see the issue as resonating with my own moral values and moral foundations, then this kind of a moral motivation would be enough to break the spiral of silence, to make people more likely to express their opinions during those interpersonal discussions. My plan is I'm trying to work or stay in academia. So I really want to continue my research in this message and social interaction. I believe that's an important issue to consider in this modern media environment, communication environment. So probably I would trying to find a position in university here in the US to spend at least several years here. But in the meantime, I want to have this connection back to China, and I wanted to be some kind of a bridge in terms of how scholars in these two quite different communities can perhaps exchange thoughts with each other. Like the workshop we once did in Beijing with Renmin, I believe is a very fruitful collaboration. And I would love to see more collaborations or exchange of thoughts that could happen in the future.